An upstate woman says a man touched her inappropriately in a grocery store parking lot, and she ended up buying him some groceries. She says she felt she had no choice.
Tonight, investigators at Spartanburg Public Safety call it a case of assault, and they want your help identifying and tracking the man down. News Force Parul Joshi is here with the story. Parul, what time of day did this happen?
Around 9 p.m. last night in Spartanburg, Kim Chapman tells me a man who appeared intoxicated touched her, kissed her hand repeatedly at Food Lion, and told her he needed groceries.
You have to be careful that there's this man out there that he needs to be caught. And he's asking women for money, but that's not what he wants.
Kim Chapman says she was loading up her groceries at Food Lion on Garner Road in Spartanburg Monday night when she says this man approached her, telling her he didn't have a home or food, just 26 cents. Chapman says she told him she didn't have any money, but he started helping her with her groceries. Then Chapman says the man went too far.
Touched me inappropriately across my back. And then I got scared and I was like, I'll tell you what, sir. You let me get my groceries in the car and I will take you back in the store to buy you groceries.
Chapman thought if she could just get inside, someone could help her. But Chapman says she didn't see anyone. So they shopped.
We get up to the register and the lady's standing there. And I'm looking at her like, no, help me. And then she's like, you know, she's trying to read my signs. And I was like, I don't know him. And she goes, you don't know him? And she said, did he ask you to come in here to buy him groceries? I said, yes.
The suspect Chapman described seems familiar to investigators. Captain Regina Novak with Spartanburg Public Safety says several days ago, a young woman was also approached in the Food Lion parking lot by a man, and he followed her inside.
He left the store and went and stood by her car. She called somebody to come meet her, to walk her to a car, and he left. So I have a feeling it's the same person, general, same description.
He had no right to touch me. He had no right to approach me that way when I told him I didn't have money. He should have walked away. He should have let me be.
Chapman says she just hopes no one else will experience what she did. And Chapman says as she was paying for the groceries, the man walked outside, and she says the manager asked him to leave. She describes him as about 5'7 and medium build with a brown hair and a beard. If you know anything that can help police, call 888-CRIME-SC. Carol?